मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर ऑफ सिविक्स, चैप्टर 1, द यूनियन लेजिस्लेचर और द यूनियन पार्लियामेंट. टुडेज टॉपिक इज द लोकसभा. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स. सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टुडे टॉपिक्स आर एज फॉलोज: कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ लोकसभा, डिविजन ऑफ स्टेट इंटू कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज, रिजर्वेशन ऑफ सीट्स, इलेक्शन टू द लोकसभा, क्वालिफिकेशन फॉर द मेंबर्स ऑफ द लोकसभा, डिसक्वालिफिकेशन ऑफ मेंबरशिप, टर्म ऑफ द लोकसभा, सेशंस ऑफ द हाउस, लैंग्वेजेस टू बी यूज्ड इन द लोकसभा पार्लियामेंट, इम्पोर्टेंस, पावर्स एंड एडवांटेजेस ऑफ लोकसभा. बिफोर स्टार्ट द टुडेज टॉपिक, लेट्स डिस्कस सम कीवर्ड्स. नंबर 1, कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज, इट मीन्स द डिस्ट्रिक्ट हु इलेक्ट अ लेजिस्लेटर. नंबर 2, एम्पावरमेंट, मीन्स मोटिवेशन. नंबर 3, प्रोक्लेम्ड, मीन्स लॉ ब्रेकर. नंबर 4, इंसॉल्वेंट, मीन्स बैंकरप्ट. नंबर 5, कॉम्पिटेंट, मीन्स एफिशिएंट. नंबर 6, सीज्ड, इट मीन्स डिसकॉन्टिन्यू. नंबर 7, प्रोक्लेमेशन, इट मीन्स डिक्लेरेशन. नंबर 8, समन्स, इट मीन्स कॉल फॉर. नंबर 9, इंटरवेन, इट मीन्स टेक प्लेस. नंबर 10, प्ररोग, इट मीन्स डिसकॉन्टिन्यू द सेशन. नंबर 11, ऑब्लाइज, इट मीन्स कंपेल. नाउ ओपन योर बुक्स. टॉपिक द लोकसभा. द लोअर हाउस ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज कॉल्ड हाउस ऑफ द पीपल और द लोकसभा, which is the representative body of the people. Composition: the maximum strength of the Lok Sabha as provided by the constitution is 552. Out of this, not more than 530 members shall represent the states, not more than 20 members shall represent the union territories, 2 members from the Anglo-Indian community shall be nominated by the president if he feels that the community has not been adequately representative. The Lok Sabha represents the people of the country, so it is also called House of People. Its composition: the maximum strength of the house allotted by the Constitution of India is 552. Out of it, 530 members are from the states, 20 members are from the union territories, 2 members from the Anglo-Indian community shall be nominated by the president if its representation is found inadequate in the house. This will be more clear from the following chart. Lok Sabha, maximum 552 members, 530 members representatives of the states, 20 members representative of the union territories, 2 members nominated by the president from the Anglo-Indian community. You can also see the inside view of the Lok Sabha. However, the effective strength of the Lok Sabha at present is 545, out of which 530 members are directly elected by states, 13 members by union territories, and 2 members are nominated by the president from the Anglo-Indian community. Seats are allotted to the different states, 28, and union territories, 9, in the Lok Sabha on the basis of their respective populations. For example, while Uttar Pradesh has 80 seats in the Lok Sabha, states with small population like those of Mizoram, Nagaland and Sikkim etc. have only one seat each in the Lok Sabha. At present, the Lok Sabha has 545 members, out of which 530 members are from states, 13 from union territories and 2 from Anglo-Indian community. Seats are allotted to different states and union territories in Lok Sabha on the basis of their population. For example, UP has 80 seats while Mizoram, Nagaland, Sikkim have only one seat in Lok Sabha. Division of state into constituencies. Constituencies means the district who elected a legislator or an officer. Each state and union territory is divided into number of areas called constituencies for election purpose. From one constituency, one member is elected. A constituency has well-marked boundaries for smooth holding of the elections. For Lok Sabha elections, the country is divided into 543 constituencies. Sometimes these constituencies are counted as seats. Each state or union territory is divided into number of areas called constituencies for elections. One member for one constituency. For Lok Sabha elections, the country is divided into 543 constituencies and these constituencies are counted as seats. At present, Punjab has 13 seats in Lok Sabha. Reservation of seats. The Indian Constitution has made provision for the socially and educationally backward classes of citizens. As such, many seats have been reserved for Scheduled Caste 84 and Scheduled Tribe 47 in the Lok Sabha. The President is empowered to nominate two members of the Anglo-Indian community to the Lok Sabha if he finds that community has inadequate representation in the House. This is to ensure that marginalized means powerless groups get political empowerment. Empowerment means motivation. The Indian Constitution has made provision for the backward classes. A total of 131 seats, 24.03% are reserved for representatives of Scheduled Caste 84 and Scheduled Tribes 47 and two members of Anglo-Indian. This is to ensure that the powerless groups also get political motivation. Election to the Lok Sabha. Members of the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people. The principle of universal adult franchise has been adopted, which means that all the citizens of the age of 18 years and above have the right to vote, if not otherwise disqualified under the law. This principle of universal adult franchise has established a true democracy or government of the people, by the people and for the people in India. Since government affect all, it must be responsible to all. This is possible if the right to vote is given to all, irrespective of this or her caste, creed, color, gender or economic status. Here lies the merit of universal adult franchise. The Lok Sabha members are elected by direct elections under universal adult franchise, means all citizens of the age of 18 years and above have the right to vote without any discrimination of social status, caste, gender or any other restrictions. This is the main quality of universal adult franchise. Not only this, the elections to the Lok Sabha are held by secret ballot, which means the voters can cast their votes secretly without any fear. They are also safe from the pulls and pressures of the politicians. Moreover, no ill feeling is created. The elections of the Lok Sabha are held secretly by using secret ballot. The people can cast their vote without any fear and pressures of the politicians. Qualifications for the members of the Lok Sabha. In order to seek election to the Lok Sabha, a person must possess the following qualification. He should be a citizen of India. He should be at least 25 years old. He should not be a proclaimed. Proclaimed means culprit or lawbreaker, offender. He should have his name in the electoral rolls in any part of the country. He or she should possess such other qualification as may be specified by Parliament from time to time. He should not hold any office of profit under the state or central government. He should not be of unsound mind. He should be an insolvent, means bankrupt. If that is, he should not be in debt. To become the member of the Lok Sabha, a candidate must be a citizen of India or more than 25 years of age. He should not be culprit. He should be a registered voter. He must possess the qualification prescribed by the Parliament. He should not hold any government office under state or central government. He should be physically or mentally fit. He should not be bankrupt. Disqualifications of membership. A member of any house of the Parliament is disqualified. Disqualified means eliminated or unqualified on the following grounds. If he holds any office of profit, either under the government of India or any of the state governments, However, the office of the ministers and deputy ministers are not regarded as office of prophet for this purpose. If he is of unsound, means not fit, and declared by any competent means any efficient court. If he is an undischarged insolvent, means bankrupt. If he has ceased means discontinue to be a citizen of India. If he has been disqualified under any law made by the Indian Parliament. A person would be ineligible for being a member of the Lok Sabha if the person holds other than office permitted by Parliament of India by law, or if the person is not mentally fit or declared him unsound mind by any efficient court, or if the person is bankrupt, or if the person is discontinued to be a citizen of India, or if he has been disqualified under any law made by the Indian Parliament. In addition to the above disqualification, the Representation of People Act 1951 as amended from time to time further adds to the list of disqualification by its members of the either house of the parliament. If he has been found guilty of certain election offences, means crime or corrupt practices means dishonest operations during election. If he has been sentenced to transportation or imprisonment for not less than 2 years, if he has been found guilty of violating means ignoring or break any law of the land, such as Narcotic and Custom Act, Dowry Act, or using cruelty towards women. It may be added here that no person can be a member of both House of the Parliament at one and the same time, nor can be a member of Central Legislature Parliament or any of the state legislature at one and the same time. In addition of the disqualification, the Representation of People's Act 1951 revised from time to add in the list of disqualification. The Representation of the People Act 1951 is an act of Parliament of India to provide for the conduct of election of houses, qualification, disqualification for membership of those houses. Now, if a person found dishonest during elections, if a person has been imprisonment for not less than 2 years, if a person break any law such as Narcotic, Custom Act, Dowry Act, or use any harsh words towards women, or no person can be member of both houses of parliament at one and the same time. Term of the Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha is normally elected for 5 years. It may be dissolved by the president before the expiry of its term on the advice of the prime minister. However, while a proclamation, means declaration, of emergency is in operation, its tenure may be extended by parliament for a period not exceeding 1 year at a time, and not extending in any case beyond a period of 6 months after the proclamation of emergency has ceased. Ceased means discontinued to operate. Members of the Lok Sabha are elected for a period of 5 years. The president can dissolve the house before completion of its term on the advice of Prime Minister. During an emergency, the term of the Lok Sabha can be extended for 1 year, but not beyond 6 months after the state of emergency has been cancelled. Now, look at the table here. State-wise allocation of seats in the two houses of the parliament. Like Bihar, 40 seats in Lok Sabha and 16 seats in Rajya Sabha. Kerala, 20 seats in Lok Sabha, 9 seats in Rajya Sabha. And like in Union Territories also, like in Jammu and Kashmir, 5 seats in Lok Sabha and 4 seats in Rajya Sabha. Now, session of the House. The period during which the House meets to conduct its business is called session. The President summons means call for the session of each House of the Parliament. Normally, there are 3 sessions of the Parliament held in a year. The budget session, February-May, the monsoon session, July-September, and the winter session, November-December. The maximum period that can intervene, means take place, between two sessions of the parliament is 6 months. The president can prorogue means suspend or discontinue the session. The parliament or any of its house, he may dissolve the Lok Sabha. The president may convene means call, a joint session of both the house as and when so required. The period during which the house members meets to conduct its meetings is called session. The president has the full power to call and discontinue the session of each house of parliament or to dissolve Lok Sabha. He can also call a joint session of both house when so required. There are 3 sessions of parliament in a year: budget session from February till May, monsoon session from July till September, and winter session November, December. Languages to be used in the Lok Sabha parliament. It is laid down that the business of parliament is to be transacted means conduct, either in Hindi or English. However, if any member is not able to express himself either in English or Hindi, the Speaker of the Lok Sabha or the Chairman of the Rajya Sabha may permit such a member to address the House in his mother tongue. Under Article 120 of the Constitution, the business of the House is to be conducted in Hindi or English language. If any member is not able to use these 2 languages, with the permission of Speaker of Lok Sabha, he or she can interact in his mother tongue also. Important powers, advantages of Lok Sabha. Of the 2 houses of parliament, that is the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, the Lok Sabha has the upper hand and has special advantages of its own. First, it controls the exchequer. Exchequer means national supply of money of the state. The money bills can be introduced only in the Lok Sabha and not in the Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha is the more powerful than the Rajya Sabha. It controls the national supply of money of the state. Money bills can only introduce in Lok Sabha. Point 2, it is the Lok Sabha which actually controls the executive. The Council of Ministers is actually responsible to the Lok Sabha. A motion of no confidence passed by the Rajya Sabha does not oblige means compel the government to resign, but a similar vote passed by the Lok Sabha makes it obligatory, means compulsory for the government to resign. Lok Sabha has full control on executive. The Council of Ministers are answerable to Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha may remove a cabinet by a vote of no confidence. It may also reject a bill or budget. In almost all other fields, the Lok Sabha has an upper hand because of the greater numeral strength of its members. It has 545 members as against 245 members of the Rajya Sabha. It is an admitted fact that the Lok Sabha is the more powerful house. Almost in all fields, Lok Sabha is more powerful than Rajya Sabha because of its strength of members than the Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha has 545 members, whereas Rajya Sabha has 245 members. Thank you.